Hey, I'm Kelvin with ArborXR, and in this video, we're going to be reviewing 5 key features we released in March. Let's get into it. So, March was another busy month for the ArborXR team. We have 5 significant features coming to ArborXR that are going to make it easier than ever to set up devices and control what users can see and do in VR. We've released a new home environment, WebXR support, video support, remote launch capabilities, and QR code enrollments. And I'll give you a quick overview of each feature right now. Starting with the ArborXR home environment, we launched a brand new redesign. Here's a side-by-side comparison of the new layout with the previous one. We've been working closely with our customers to make sure ArborXR Home is providing the best experience for both users and admins. First, we added hand tracking support for Pico, Quest, and Vive devices. So now users can interact in VR without hand controllers. We also improved the stability of hand tracking pointers by moving the UI closer to end users. And we added sound effects and animations to cue end users when something is selected to make it much more intuitive and easier to navigate. Admins can also take control of the colors in the ArborXR home environment. You can customize to your organization's preference. And there are new ways to launch content. Admins can pin apps, videos, and WebXR links to the launcher now. And since I mentioned it, let's quickly take a look at the next feature on our list, WebXR links. WebXR is a huge new development for XR training. It's actually much easier and cheaper to create web-based training scenarios and keep them updated compared to building an entire training app from the ground up. Typically, XR has been limited to the apps downloaded to a user's device. However, WebXR links make it easier and quicker to access certain types of content from within the headset. You'll see clicking on a WebXR link immediately opens the browser and content. And that means users won't have to manually type in VR to open up the URL. Next, let's take a quick look at the added support you'll see for video in the ArborXR home environment. You'll now be able to pin shortcuts to 360, 180, and 2D videos, which means no more having to download third-party video player apps and launch videos through those apps. With ArborXR's video support, users can one-click launch videos anytime they need. Moving right along, let's talk about remote launch capabilities. Remotely launching content gives you complete control over what users see and do in VR. You've been able to remotely launch apps in ArborXR for over a year, but now you can also launch WebXR content and videos remotely via the web portal. The last feature we want to cover in this video is QR code enrollment. QR code enrollment can save you loads of time because it gives you another quick and easy option for setting up devices without plugging them into a computer or toggling on developer options. To set up this new enrollment method, make your way to the settings of a device group in the web portal. And under enrollment, you'll now see QR codes as an option. Also, for quick reference, as of March 2023, here are the devices that currently support QR code enrollment. The Pico Neo 3, Magic Leap 2, RealWear devices, Vuzix devices, and tablets. It is also important to note that some popular XR headsets like the Meta Quest do not offer a QR code enrollment method at this time. There are also some other challenges associated with using the Quest, and we've added a link right down below in the comments section in case you would like to learn more about those challenges. And there you have it. Those are some of the big features we launched this month, and we also have a lot of things planned for the near future, and we can't wait to share them with you. If you'd like to keep track of our product roadmap or demo any of these features, we would love to hear from you. Feel free to reach out to us anytime at arborxr.com. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll talk to you in the next one.